Good morning, welcome to Convocation 2015. How about the drum line? From Magnolia West High School, please give them a round of applause. Here we go. So it's my honor to get to start this thing off. We hope that this is a morning that gives you a shot in the arm, gets you excited about what you're about to get to do in working with kids this year. And we have a lot of things that have become tradition here in Magnolia ISD, and I think we have a good morning in store for you. So to get us started, I want to invite Christy Baker, one of our school board members, up to lead our opening. Ms. Baker.
Good morning, everyone. If you choose to join me in prayer, I invite you to bow your head. We come to you this morning, Lord, with praise and thanksgiving for the time that we have had to recharge our batteries, spend time with our families and loved ones. We also come to you this morning, Lord, to ask you to please sit with us in our classrooms, in our offices, in our clinics, in our administration building. Please sit with us. Guide us in your ways, give us your peace, your strength, and let us feel your attaboys when we do a good job, Lord, so that we are continually revived this school year and every school year thereafter to give our children the very best that lies within us. In Jesus Christ's holy name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Ms. Baker. If I could ask you to rise for our Navy Junior ROTC program, presents our colors. Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by the Texas Pledge. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now the Texas Pledge. Honor the Texas flag. Please remain standing while our Magnolia West High School band performs our Star Spangled Banner. Please remain standing while the colors are retired. Thank you, and you may be seated. Well, thank you again to the Magnolia West High School Band under the direction of Pat Crompton. Outstanding job this morning. And I have a few other recognitions to share with you. One, we want to thank Chick-fil-A for breakfast. Done with the support and help of our Magnolia ISD Food Service. Thank you to those folks also. Again, a thank you to our Navy Junior ROTC and Magnolia West High School Band. And I would like to recognize a group that provides a lot of support for our schools and are very visible in our community. Precinct 5, the Montgomery County Constables are here this morning. If those guys would be recognized, I would appreciate that. And a special guest that some of you may recognize is on our stage. I'm going to embarrass him and ask him to stand. Charlie Riley is a former school board member and is our great guy that helps us in this community with the county. We appreciate our Commissioner Charlie Riley. And now I'd like to introduce our superintendent, Dr. Todd Stevens. Dr. Stevens.
Thank you, Dr. Bullitt, and good morning, Magnolia ISD. It's great to see you this morning. Again, for another year, I am honored to have a chance to serve you as your superintendent for Magnolia ISD. And it's a... And it really is good to see all of you in one place. You know, we only get to do this one time a year, where we all come together, we've got Bulldogs and Mustangs here, and you know, sitting next to each other, and you know, as we grow, we're going to probably outgrow this, but it is a special time when we have to come here and to kind of set ourselves apart for the work that we have going on today. And you know, you guys look rested and refreshed. I hope you had a great summer and you're ready to get back and get started. I hope you had a chance maybe to travel, do a little fishing, or work around the house, or maybe you just had a chance to maybe sleep late and watch a little early morning TV with some coffee, you know. But anyway, I hope you had a great summer. Ms. Stevens and I did a little traveling. We went down to Puerto Rico, spent a little time there. Beautiful water, you know, in the sun. We helped out some with the debt situation down there in Puerto Rico. You know, things going on. I don't know if that could be left. I'm not sure why that situation is still intact. We also did a little remodeling around the house, did a little painting on the outside, and got the bathrooms remodeled. And you know, we have the new shower door and all that stuff on it. So now every time we get through showering, I have to take a squeegee and squeegee that off. You know, you'll think about your superintendent doing that every morning. And I squeegee my shower, not because I love my shower door, but because I love my wife. And that is all I'm going to say about that. We also had a chance to take our two kiddos down to Rockport for a long weekend, and we had a grand time together just visiting. And, you know, for our new teachers, both our kids are just recently out of school, last couple of years, and independent and working, those kind of things. And so we had a great time down there. You know, we went to Rockport, and if you've been down to Rockport, there's a restaurant down there, it's kind of famous, it's called the Boiling Pot. You know, they come out and they pour all the crabs and lobster and stuff on the table up there. And you know, of course, we're getting ready to eat. Of course, our kids are going, wait. They have to get the phones out because, you know, they have to take pictures of all that and post it on Facebook. You know, Miss Stevens is a new Facebooker too, because you might want to friend her. She just recently got her Facebook page up and put pictures of her dog up there on it. So maybe you're now befriending her, because she didn't have any friends to start with. And you know, new teachers to the district. You know, it's always tradition. I got to talk a little bit about our grand dog, Brody. And we have a grand dog that lives with us. And obviously, like all grandchildren, he's very special to us. You know, But he started off his life at Texas Tech in a sorority, and then came to live with grandparents. And so this past year, our daughter Holly, who teaches in Conroe ISD, was home working with him, and she teaches him a lot of some of his dog antics or tricks, but she taught him how to speak and to whisper, you know, on command. And so she made a little 6-second video and posted that on YouTube. And Brody this past year was a YouTube phenomenon. And he's going on like 3 million hits on YouTube of a 6-second deal of Brody whispering. So if you want to check out Brody, not now, but if you have some time, you can Google Brody the Amazing Talking Dog, and he comes right up, and you'll have a chance to look at his 6 seconds of fame. You know, he was running there pretty good until the grumpy puppy knocked him out of contention, you know. And two people know that grumpy puppy or part of that. But, all right, before we go any farther, something I enjoy doing every year. Everybody stand up. And it's time for us to officially start off this 2015-2016 school year. And I want to hear some shouts of joy that we got this started when we finally do it. So with the power that's invested in me by the Texas Education Agency and the Magnolia ISD Board of Trustees, and just because I get to because I'm the superintendent, it's my pleasure to officially start the 2015-2016 school year right now. Thank you. You may be seated. You got that properly done. Feel better about it. If you are a new teacher to Magnolia ISD, would you please stand up? Quite a few brand new first-year teachers in that group also. I had a chance to talk to them last week, I think it was maybe Wednesday, and welcome them to the district. And just in that little kind of visit, you know, I told them, and I think all of us will agree, that we're welcoming them to a very special place in Magnolia ISD. A lot of great things are happening here in this district. And it's really because of the great people that we've assembled here and the support that we have from our community and our board of trustees. And all those things are kind of working as an alchemy to help build what we want to refer to as the best district in the state of Texas. So welcome here. And you can form your own opinions about it. But I firmly believe it's a great place. I would not want to work in any other district in the state of Texas as we continue our process of building this district into the best one in the state of Texas. For all of us, and I shared this with our new teachers, part of the reason we come here today and we call this convocation, obviously so we can start the school year and hear stories about Brody and those kind of things. But the reason we come here is to remind ourselves collectively of the importance of the work that we do with our kiddos. And there's a lot of people that get up and go to work every day. And there are a lot of important things that have to happen across this world. But I believe there is none in terms of what we do in a job that's any more important than the job we undertake each and every day with our students. You guys realize, and I say it, I know you know this, but I just want to remind you, the work you do collectively will pay dividends in our kids. And that's part of why we light a candle and we remind ourselves that we have a student who is leading with all those years of input that we have had in working with them to go out into this world. We touch the future, the work we do. Never forget that opportunity. And you have more of an opportunity to do that than any of us back up here have. And never forget that. And never forget the importance of what we do. And we're here to remind each other of that. And that's the whole purpose of our candle lighting ceremony. And so I do enjoy today. You know, we couldn't do many of the things that happen in this district without the support of our community. And I love the fact that in Texas Public Schools, you know, we have a very grassroots organic system where we have moms and dads or taxpayers that are elected to represent collectively the parents and that community to ensure that the focus is on the right thing. And I want to tell you that in my, you know, 15-something years in Magnolia ISD, I firmly believe that this is the best board of trustees that we have ever had in Magnolia ISD. They're assembled right here on this stage. And so I want to introduce them, and you can applaud for them individually, but when we get them all finally standing, I want to make sure they get a standing ovation for the work that they do in Magnolia ISD. We are a team of eight, maybe 9, 10, by the time we add our assistant superintendents and finance folks in that. And we play off of each other's strengths. There's some very talented people on this board. They bring a lot of professional expertise, and I'll tell you that I use that all the time. And as we meet, I want you to hear that their focus is on making sure you have the tools and the resources you need to make sure that the magic happens with our kiddos. They're a very special group, and I am so pleased to have a chance to work with them. In terms of the resources, another year of 4% salary raises for our employees in Magnolia ISD. Thank you, board. And they got a board meeting tonight, and in that board meeting, I fully expect they're going to call for a $92 million bond package to also make sure you have the resources to do the job that you need. Thank you, board, for that. And even in light of calling that $92 million bond package, they're going to lower the tax rate tonight for our taxpayers. So thank you for that, board members. Let's recognize our Board of Trustees. Our Board President is Mr. Steve Cruz. Our Vice President is Mr. Gary Blizzard. And he is absent today, but our Secretary is Mr. Chuck Adcox. And to help him along is Assistant Secretary is Ms. Christy Baker. We have Trustee Deborah Rose Miller, Trustee Joe Duncan, and last but certainly not least, we have Trustee Travis Moffitt. And look, Dr. Moffitt is our newest board member, and I just wanted to give him an opportunity to come up here and say hi, because many of you, although he's out all over the community, many of you maybe haven't had an opportunity to meet him or hear from him, but I just want him to say hi. He's not delivering the board's address. Dr. Cruz is going to do that here in just a second. But Travis, would you come up here and just say hi to everybody? You know, in case you get confused about him, he has one distinguishing physical characteristic that distinguishes him. He has these kind of green eyes.
And I want you to know that I appreciate what you guys do, and I am so looking forward to being even just a small part of what this board does and what this school district does. Thank you very much.
Mr. Steve Cruz he served on this board for over 9 years, I believe. He and his going on 9 years, and he and his wife, Renee, have raised a son in this school district, and Renee obviously retired from this district, but, you know, Steve is very special, and he's serving this year as our board president,
You know, Steve's one of those guys that never could figure out exactly what he wanted to do. He went to A&M and got an engineering degree. He went on to Baylor and got a law degree. And now he's a surveyor. So, he just kind of dabbles in all sorts of things. Even does some time as a judge here in the county's park. But we're so pleased to have him. And so to give our board's charge and welcome, Mr. Steve Cruz.
Thank you, Dr. Stevens. I was going to say, Dr. Stevens is a tough act to follow with all those funny stories that he was saying earlier. Before I get started, though, I want us to give one more big round of applause to the Magnolia Chick-fil-A, Kendrick Skipper and his whole crew there. They do such a great job, and they are so supportive of our district. We're just so thankful to have Chick-fil-A here. Would you give them another round? First of all, I want to welcome you back, or I guess I should say, in many cases, welcome you as we prepare for another great year here at Magnolia ISD. I'm going to borrow a phrase from Jeff Springer. It's a great day to be alive. It's a great day to be part of Magnolia ISD, the best district in the state of Texas. Let me let that sink in. Yes, I did say that. Most of, if not all of you, know that our district's motto is dedicated to be the best district in the state of Texas. Well, I'm a little biased. I think we already are the best district in the state of Texas. But I'm gonna say this. It's not because of me, the board, or the other board members sitting up here. It's because of all of you out there. You see, I am a little biased, but I think we have the best teachers, the best principals, and the best administrators in the state. Now give yourselves a big hand. You know, to support that observation, I'm gonna say this. 4 out of the last 7 years, one of our teachers of the year has been honored to be the Region 6 Teacher of the Year. In addition to that, 3 out of the last 4 years, one of our principals has been honored to be the Principal of the Year for Region 6. And lastly, but certainly not least, this year, we have the Superintendent of the Year for Region 6. I'm going to introduce John Connolly from Region 6, who's here to make a special award to our superintendent, Dr. Stevens. I'm also going to ask Mrs. Les Miller to come up here and share. She had so much to do with getting this award moved along, so come on up, Deborah. And Dr. Stevens, come on up here. We have an award. But I want to turn it over right now to John Connolly with Region 6.
Thank you, Mr. Cruz. Appreciate it. First of all, a couple quick observations. Wow, what a colorful group. I was really impressed by the different shirts and everything. Gosh, you guys are really ready for school. I couldn't tell if you just had too long a summer, it was too hot, you're ready to come back where the air conditioning is consistent. But it's obvious you're glad to be back. And the other thing that I want to say, a quick observation that's representative of why you're going to see Dr. Stevens receive this award was, the first thing he said was about serving you. And the mark of a great leader is about service. And so I want to make sure, and I think you all, those of you that know Dr. Stevens, probably over the years have been around here longer, maybe than he has in some cases. And if you're brand new, you're going to learn this. Dr. Stevens is very well respected, not just around the region, but I think around the state. I've only known him probably really well for about the last couple of years, and one of the things that stood out was his just being a very genuine person, very much a person that cares about children, about their welfare, and also about the people that work with those kids. So you're very fortunate to have a leader like Dr. Stevens at the helm of Magnolia. And this is entitled the Superintendent of the Year. It could be the Leader of the Year. And I think that would very well describe Dr. Stevens. So I want to congratulate you, Todd. You're very deserving of this. They brought in school board members to actually make the selection. I don't think anybody from Magnolia was on that selection crew. I think it was done independently of that. So he was handpicked and very deserving of this. I'd like to read to you real quick what it says. It says Region 6 Education Service Center recognizes Dr. Todd Stevens, Magnolia ISD, Region 6 Superintendent of the Year 2015. Now, having said that, would you like to say a few words? Because we're going to have a quick video following either your comments, or if you don't want to right now, you want to wait, it's up to you.
Well, I am deeply honored, and again, to have a chance to serve as superintendent in this district. And I need to be clear that I accept this, but I'm not accepting it just for this. This is not a Todd Stevens issue. It's because I've got a great board of trustees that I have an opportunity to work with, and they helped me make the right decisions about moving this district forward. Now, I have an outstanding team of administrators that are a lot smarter than I am to make me look good on a regular basis. I have a great secretary, assistant, and Christine for them. Helps to do it. So last of all, I thank my wife for allowing me to have the time to put in to do this job the way it needs to be done. So on behalf of all those things in Magnolia ISD, then maybe I will accept that.
Well, let me present you with a quick clap. Congratulations, Todd.
Well, good morning, Magnolia ISD. I'm so honored to be with you guys this morning, even though it's not live. But I wanted to take this opportunity to make sure that I came today to be able to let you know how proud we are of Dr. Todd Stevens, Superintendent of the Year for Region 6. And, you know, all of you probably know Todd and I go back 35 years that we've been together off and on, and, you know, truly came to Magnolia together in 99 and really had a dream. And then he took that over in 2009 and continued that dream. And no one's more proud of Todd than I am to be our Superintendent of the Year. Todd, you know, you're my dearest friend, you're my colleague, and you're my brother. And I just want to congratulate you. I also have a little special treat for you today. With my pool with the commissioner, you're the only Superintendent of the Year nominee for the state that the commissioner is going to congratulate as well. So I'm going to turn it over to the commissioner. Magnolia, have a great year. Love all of you. Take care, and good luck this year.
Todd, I just wanted to come and congratulate you. You know, you've been doing great work there in Magnolia ISD, and I wanted to say thank you for what you've done, and I wanted to commend you for it, and then tell you in advance, I look forward to having a chance to visit with you during the school year. Congratulations.
Someone who's been married to an educator for the last 27 plus years, I have great respect and admiration for what all of you do, and I just want you to know that. I know most of all of you have heard it before, and at the risk of sounding redundant, I want to assure you that this board has one agenda and one agenda only, and that is to do what's best for the students of this district. That pretty much says it all, along with Dr. Stevens' favorite phrase. I'm surprised he hadn't been used it yet this morning. Keeping the main thing the main thing. And, you know, we've heard that, and, you know, maybe I'm the only one that's wondered, well, what is the main thing? Well, for those of you who may be wondering this, I actually was at a seminar this summer, and I think I heard a definition that If it's not the right definition, it's one that I'd like to use. The main thing is helping our students learn. And I think that's what the main thing is. And I want to assure you that we as a board are here to help you help our students learn. And if there's anything we can do to assist you in doing that better, we will be more than happy to do that. Now, that's all I'm going to say for this morning. I would like for you to all give Dr. Stevens one more round of applause for being our superintendent. As I said, we as a board appreciate what you do, and we fully support what you do. Like Dr. Stevens said, I think teaching, being an educator, is one of the most noble, honorable, important jobs in our country. And at this time, I'm going to turn the program over to Dr. Heber.
Assistant Superintendent of Curriculum and Instruction, and I'm so proud to welcome you guys today. We've had a great honor bestowed, but we did miss actually giving our board, who nominated Dr. Stevens, and all of the work that he does to recognize them, we miss giving them their standing ovation and all of the support that they provide to us. So let's do that at this time. Show our appreciation to the honor for standing ovation. At this time, we also want to share with you, we talked a lot about Magnolia ISD and what makes it great. Being the best district in the state of Texas is a lot to live up to. We have a video that we put together to be able to share with our community, and the new teachers got the sneak preview last week, but we wanted to share it with all of you, some things we're proud about in Magnolia ISD.
Our vision for this district is to become the best district in the state of Texas, and that's not necessarily a destination, but it's something about the culture here, and for the 15 years that I've been a part of it, it's been about improving and developing that culture. You know, you put great people in front of kiddos, and you make sure you support them and give them the tools they need, and then the magic begins to happen.
We really believe in charting an individual trail, and that students and teachers being able to reach their own potential and move forward with their own personality and achieve their goals. And that's a much bigger thing than just passing a math test. It is really about becoming the best that you can be.
We're not a one-size-fits-all district. We don't believe all children are the same. We don't try to give you a goal to reach. We try to find out what your goal is and then give you every tool to reach it.
Through it all, we know that we are focused on student success and we are focused on providing the best education possible for our community.
Our teachers push us academically. They expect the best of us and they expect us to work hard, but it really makes us into great students. My teachers have developed this drive in me to want to go further and pursue my education and just achieve all that I can achieve.
The curriculum that Magnolia ISD offered, we noticed that not only were there pre-AP and AP opportunities for those kids who want to go to college and beyond, there were also other curriculum that dealt with even floral design, auto mechanics, cosmetology, things that kids might want to do that don't have anything to do with college.
Be it on the concert stage, the athletic field, in ag, those things are great for kids. It gives a kid a chance to develop self-confidence. It gives a kid a chance to express their passions. Students that feel fed by that, that get a chance to express themselves in those ways, that self-confidence bleeds over into the classroom. There is an undercurrent of community value and civic responsibility that is taught to students so that when they do leave us, our kids are prepared to take on the world.
I've even gotten to take advanced math classes because I want to be an engineer, and it's just perfect. I get the practice of the math. I just get a feeling of how college is really going to be like, and I feel prepared. Magnolia is just an amazing district. I mean, they care about their kids. You know, we come here, we get a great education. We have all these extra activities that we get to do outside of school, so it's not just about the academics.
You know that you're taken care of, and that the teachers are here to ensure the best possible outcome for you.
There are career and tech options for kids that they're able to, we're going to prepare them for workplace settings and that they can come out with certificates that make them work ready. We have advanced placement courses, and we also have a new International Baccalaureate or IB program that we're going to offer. It'll be the only one of those such programs in Montgomery County.
When you look at the graduates each year, you can see a distinct improvement because a higher percentage of kids are going to college, and the colleges are going to are higher and higher quality.
Our kids going into even an international university, they were prepared, and I feel like they got it all from here. My daughter that plays soccer, she lives in a city now, and she still has those values that I've seen her grow with here.
Everybody plays as far as the role of being student-centered and being dedicated to students.
Teachers teaching them the right ways to do things and just really becoming great little people so that as they move on to junior high and high school that they're really the best that they can be.
It's that continual striving toward being the best that even when we reach peaks and we celebrate with our students, our teachers, and our community, we're able to then look, okay, what's next?
It's always my distinct pleasure to stand before you and to continue one of our great traditions. When we start each year, it is a time to renew and think about who we are and what we're called to do. And one of the ways that we do that is we ask our teachers of the year to come before us and charge us with being the best and to speak from their heart about what being a teacher means. And so I'm very excited this morning to introduce to you Chris Kanick, the District Teacher of the Year from Magnolia Parkway Elementary School. Let's welcome Chris.
Thank you very much. Zoltan Kodai wrote, Let us take our children seriously. Everything else follows from this, and only the best is good enough for a child. Kodai's insight intended that our children deserve the best educators. However, we educators have the best job in the world. We are privileged to help children learn and grow. We give our students our best, and in return, only accept the best from our students. Our children depend on us to believe in them. We expect and believe that they are doing their best. We recognize and support their progress and acknowledge their positive effort. We ask them about their goals and their dreams, and we concentrate on what they have accomplished. We acknowledge and celebrate every measure of growth and truly support our children. No matter how challenging our work as teachers is, we stand empowered to see it through. As adults, we have days when we feel that the world is on our side and days when life does not seem fair. There are obviously days we need encouraging words or a helping hand. As we go through the process of meeting our demands as teachers, we see in our students these very same needs and emotions. From their perspective and through their eyes, everything could be going their way or nothing could be going their way. They could need help emotionally, physically, academically, are everything at the same time in some confusing mixture. This is our opportunity to be a teacher. With an empathetic sigh, we put our lives aside and devote our attention to helping our children. We become part of their lives, their families, their friendships. We become mentors and friends. As we share stories and emotions, we become examples to be imitated. We share skills and knowledge, encouragement, faith, hope, and love. As a result, our students aspire to be writers, scientists, carpenters, mechanics, firemen, policemen, and with respect and devotion, they aspire to be teachers. The teaching learning experience cannot be left to chance. Every minute that we spend with our children could be the minute that a connection is formed. We have the ability to make their dreams and goals become reality. Again, it is a privilege to have the best job in the world. We listen to our children, and we offer understanding, compassion, and humanity. We listen and believe in our children as they grow to believe in themselves. We believe that our children are the best and dwell on any and all progress. Our experience, our imagination, our faith, our hope allow us to visualize and interpret the dreams of our students. Despite the challenges of learning and growing, Magnolia ISD educators believe that every student can embrace the positive and make the best come true. Hans Christian Andersen said, "Where words fail, music speaks." And there is no doubt that through the eyes of the child, all things are possible. Always thought you were the best. I guess I always will. Always felt that we were blessed, and I feel that way still. Sometimes we took the hard road, but we always saw it through. If I had only one friend left, I'd want it to be you. Sometimes the world was on our side, sometimes it wasn't fair. Sometimes it gave a helping hand, sometimes we didn't care. 'Cause when we were together, it made the dream come true. If I had only one friend left, I'd want it to be you. Someone who understands me and knows me inside out, and helps keep me together and believes without a doubt that I can move a mountain, someone to tell it to. If I had only one friend left, I'd want it to be you.
Thank you, Mr. Canning, for reminding us to always bring our talents every day to our classroom and be the best, be that person that they never forget. So thank you for that. Second today, we have another Teacher of the Year, our Secondary Teacher of the Year, who will now come to the mic and give us a charge. Please welcome Jennifer Bailey, Secondary Teacher of the Year from Bear Branch Junior High School.
Being selected by my peers and district leaders for the Secondary Teacher of the Year for Magnolia, it really means a lot to me, both personally and as an educator. As a young child, I have a little picture to prove it. Sorry. Before I began even attending school, I would sit in my room for hours and I would play teacher for just all day. And I can probably say that all of my stuffed animals knew all their ABCs, 1, 2, 3s, and they stayed in their chairs and did not talk nonstop. Well, I've come a long way from teaching stuffed animals. And since then, I have been a student, an undergrad, a grad student, and a working mom. And on the outside, I seemed to have it all, but on the inside, something was always missing. Missing until the day that I received the keys to my very first classroom. Ever since that magical day in August 2004, I have experienced more highs and lows than all the roller coasters, in fact, the top 10 roller coasters in the state of Texas. Now, if you don't know this already about me, I love roller coasters. I love them so much, but I love teaching way more than I love roller coasters. When I talk with people who are not teachers or even in the field of education at all, they often want to know what the best thing about being a teacher is. So I let them in on some of our secrets. Teachers get to share their passion every single day. We have the opportunity to spread the joy of knowledge even to those who don't yet love our subject matter. Teachers get to be part of many students' lives. Many of our students come to us with varying needs and backgrounds and family dynamics. And just as we would with our own children, we spend a lot of time loving them unconditionally, taking them for who they are, and helping them to grow and learn while they're with us. Many of these students and their families become part of our lives well beyond that short time that they are with us. And the cool part is we get to be the best aunt or uncle that our students will ever love, and they really do miss us when they leave. Teachers get to play, act, entertain, and be entertained. And we have more fun on the job than most adults I know, except for circus clowns. Teachers become an important part of a student's formative life experiences. We strive to be part of those positive experiences as much as possible. And this can be extra challenging if you teach math. Teachers always get a high five or a hug when we run into our students in a store or restaurant. It's great to see their expression when they realize that we really don't live at the school and we are real people. Teachers get warm fuzzies every time a former student comes back to visit, sends an email, stalks us on Facebook, just to say that they really did learn a lot from us and wish we could move to high school to be their teacher now. In fact, that happened on Friday when I was up here. It was really cool. Oh, and a few students love to give us a hug and throw in that they feel bad that they were a little too energetic and were the reason we had to dye our gray hairs. And yes, teachers do get to enjoy Thanksgiving, Christmas, spring break, and summers off. But after the initial excitement wears off, we often sit and quietly reflect on the year we had. The good, the bad, the highs, the lows. And we realize we wouldn't have it any other way and excitedly start preparing for the upcoming year and our new kids. Finally, teaching is the most important job there is. We push, prod, shape, mold, and inspire young people to dream big and work hard. Many days we are the ones that, you know, provide them pencils or PBJs, or sometimes we just listen because they just need someone to be in their corner. We set the foundation for all other professions that our kids can set their sights on. We give them the gift of knowledge that can never, ever be returned or taken away. We really do make a difference. As we all know, a teacher's job is never done. For myself, this is certainly true. I will continue to feed my passion for learning and share that passion with my students. I will continue to always strive to do more and be better. I hope to be a positive role model of what it means to be a lifelong learner for my students and an educational leader for my peers. I feel so blessed and honored to be part of the Magnolia ISD family. Thank you again. Ceremony tradition. We start by lighting the candle of knowledge. Steve Cruz, our school board president, and Dr. Stevens will light this important and substantial flame. It stands for truth and honesty, integrity. It stands for the ability to think and reason well. It stands for care and nurture, and the hope for the future. For all the things our community wants our students to learn as we teach them our respective disciplines. This candle burns brightly as a visible symbol of the work our school board and our community commissioned us to this coming school year.
And now we light candles signifying the unity of our school district and the people and programs who support our campuses. Our MISD directors will come forward representing the programs and departments that support our district.
Our curriculum directors represent the excellence we strive for in our classrooms. Let's welcome Director of Social Studies, Brenda Martin. Director of ELA and Reading, Susie McKinney. Director of Mathematics, Susie Johnson. Director of Science, Laurel Frank. Director of Special Programs, Lynn Blair. Director of Assessment and Accountability, Amy Locker. Director of Bilingual ESL, Dr. Elizabeth Torres. Director of Special Education, Kendra Wiggins. Director of Student Success Programs, and finally, lighting the candle for this group is Dr. Matt Clark, Director of CTE.
Our administration directors represent the support we provide to our students and campuses. Please welcome Director of Communication, Denise Myers. Director of Fine Arts, Dr. Foy Campbell. Executive Director of Facilities, Tim Brenner. Director of Maintenance, Arthur Sandiford. Director of Food Service, Kimberly Ullendorf. Director of Human Resources, Michael Daniel. Director of Athletics, Ray Conjura. Director of Teams and Data, Paul Hudson. Director of Technology, Rod Lear. Director of Transportation, Joe Devies. Director of Student Services and lighting the candle for this group, Rob Stewart. And
now we will light the candles of the school community. Our principals will come forward, representing their school community and signifying the importance of the work of each individual campus as part of the collective whole.
Tammy Haley, Lyon Elementary School.
Kelly Jones, Williams Elementary. Connie Polinski, Ellisor Elementary.
Harry Quinn, Nichols Sawmill Elementary.
Linda Conjura, Magnolia Elementary. Magnolia Junior High.
Dean Frederick, Alpha Academy.
Keith Dorman, DAEP.
Dr. Brandon Garza, Magnolia West High School.
Jeff Springer, Magnolia High School.
Our teachers of the year will now step forward to light the candles of the educators. Each year, we as educators must dedicate and refocus our efforts on learning and the work of knowledge that we seek to engage our students in. Our school community has entrusted us with their most precious resources and tasked us with a moral obligation to instill the values and virtues that are the bedrock of our society. We pass those values and virtues to our students through the work required during acquisition of knowledge. Teachers, let us remember that is the real purpose of our work. Our work is the noblest all professions. The flame of knowledge must burn bright and boldly from those who are called teachers.
At this time, we introduce Amanda Sass, valedictorian from Magnolia High School class of 2015. She will attend the University of Texas to major in political communication and to begin her life journey. She represents the culmination of all we do in teaching and caring for students. Her life will be a reflection of the work of all of us, and our work will be magnified by the work that she does. Through her and all the students we influence, we change the world. Let's congratulate Amanda as she carries her candle out to begin her journey.
This year. She represents our dedication to our students, to the hope we have as they enter our class. Riley and all like her, dream of success. So let's all rise and join with me as we collectively dedicate ourselves to the noble work before us. Riley, light your candle.
Let's have a great school year.
Thank you all. Have a great school year. You're dismissed.